My name is Shuichi Kotani. I am a soba noodle chef at Worldwide Soba Inc. Today, I'm going to make this buckwheat flour into soba noodle. Today, I'm making 100% buckwheat soba noodle. I will do this in four steps: making dough, rolling, cutting, and plating. First, I will make the dough. First, I filter the buckwheat flour. I put buckwheat into the konebachi. I added water little by little because if everything put together one time is cannot be even, smooth. This is mizumashi process. While making soba, I close eyes, always close eyes. Because my eyes can see only one dimension, but my finger can see a 10 dimension. So mixing process, I using three type motion. First motion is like a no, Japanese language no. That is like a sand garden. And then second motion is like a eruption of the volcano. So third motion is like a ocean, like a wave of ocean. ¥100% buckwheat soba is most difficult noodle in the world because buckwheat doesn't have a gluten. Gluten is like a glue. So if you cut the dough, cut the noodle, cannot fix. And then all process have to be done within 20 minutes. Otherwise, it start to break. Usually in Japan, 80% buckwheat and 20% gluten flour. If you buy in the grocery store dry soba noodle, that is already mixed with some gluten or wheat flour. It feels ready to make dough when it feels like usagi no unko. Japanese say usagi no unko is texture like rabbit poo-poo. And then now making dough. This process is the most important. The process is kone. This is kone. I'm making like a hana, flower. I'm imagining a flower opening up. Buckwheat dough cannot knead it over 100 times, otherwise start to break or texture is getting too soft. I'm waiting for the texture is al dente. And then after making a beautiful dough, this process is a kukuri, looks like an acorn. Now making dough is done. Next step is rolling dough. I'm using three type of rolling pin. The black rolling pin is a kokutan. Kokutan is a main rolling pin for this process. And then other two is a makibo. Makibo is a wrapping pin. First step, I'm using my hand to make the dough 2 centimeters before using rolling pin. This white flower is a buckwheat too. Comes from a center of buckwheat seeds. Is a uchiko. And then I start to rolling, spread out to 1.5 millimeters. This is Japanese Tokyo style soba noodle. This process is very delicate process. Soba need to be moving. If I'm stop, then start to break. Cannot stop until all done. Doing this process, my hand looks like a cat paw. And then this process is a tsunodashi. Tsunodashi is a making corner. After do this and making a circle to square. This process is a nikuwake. If break the dough, this process cannot fix. If using 80% buckwheat flour, you can fix. But 100% cannot fix. This is a Honnoshi final rolling process. It's a make sure each section is evenly smooth, and I check final size.This is my life work, so I'm always learning more this technique. My teacher, he's a master of the soba noodle chef, and he teach me 3 years in Tokyo. And then every day start to work early morning, I remember 4 a.m. Because buckwheat noodle is very delicate for the high temperature. So early morning, is the kitchen is very cold. It's better for making soba noodle.If you want to be a master of the soba noodle, have to work over 10 years. Now rolling is done. Next step is folding and cutting. I'm folding it 3 times, making same size of soba bocho. Soba bocho is a soba knife.So this studio light is a little bit hot to a buckwheat flour. It's easy to break, so making break. 100% buckwheat flour is for me is very difficult to make in perfect, like a treasure hunt. This is a mana ita. This is cutting board. I'm making a cushion because soba knife is straight.Edge is very straight, so sometimes it's difficult cutting to end. This is a koma ita. This is a cutting guide board. And then I put the buckwheat on the cushion.My knife is 3 pounds, and then size is 1 foot. This knife is edge one side, but another side is a scoop for the noodle. And then grip is shark skin to non-slip. This knife cost between $1,000 to $8,000.This is from Mr. Sakai. He's an expert of the Japanese samurai sword. That's why so very expensive. cutting process is、difficult because have to make same size evenly. Tokyo area is a very business town, so everybody eat quickly. So should be a thin noodle. My style is a Edo-kiri soba style. Edo-kiri soba should be 1.5 millimeter. Edo is a Tokyo style.Most popular is Edo-giri soba, but Japan has many different style. So 100% buckwheat should be fresh for the customer. Otherwise, after 3 hours start to break in the refrigerator. This wooden box can keep the moisture because after making noodle, buckwheat start to breathe and getting watery. So wooden box absorb water.So cutting is done, and the final step is plating. So I'm cutting scallion. Fresh scallion is too strong for the fish broth. It's have to wash before using.Traditional buckwheat soba noodle enjoy with bonito fish broth and then scallion and then grind wasabi, but today is I using grind ginger. I'm boiling buckwheat soba noodle and boiling time is 1 minute.Usually, dry packaged soba noodle should be boiling 4 minutes, 5 minutes, but a fresh buckwheat soba noodle just 1 minute. Fresh buckwheat soba noodle have to touch soft, have to pressure cook, so have to put the cover.So I'm using a zaru. Zaru is a sifter. And then immediately put to a cold ice water. Ice water stop cooking, ice shock. And then feeling texture fine to al dente.Best way to plating is a.Lift and separate noodle is better for the buckwheat noodle. Now soba is done. So this is the process for turning buckwheat flour into soba.